Tutoring, then you will let your instructor know, and the instructor may be able to set up some one-on-one sessions with you, or they may be able to set up a group session with the class outside of the class time for you to get some tutoring. But for these sessions that are listed on this form, if you find you're in your classes and you think you need some extra help, you just show up on whatever day and whatever time with your questions and just be prepared to ask those questions. Now, some students think that they have to go to the instructor. For instance, if you need tutoring and your instructor is B. Hart, you don't necessarily have to go to his tutoring session. You can go to Mr. Jimmy DeBrees if you wanted to get help in that. If the times that we have, if you find that they are not convenient for you, if they conflict with maybe your work schedule, then the person you need to speak with is Ms. Cindy Phillips. Her name and her room number is at the bottom of this form. But I'll tell you, she is located in the rear of room 166, which is the Success Lab. And you'll all become familiar with the Success Lab. It's in this building. It's also the lab where we have computers. Students can go in there, they can study, they can work on the computers, and it's across from the library. And that is our Success Lab. So if you have any issues with tutoring times, or maybe you need tutoring in another subject, you haven't been able to talk with the instructor, you may want to talk to Ms. Cindy Phillips. She may be able to help you navigate through that process. So that's the first thing, tutoring. I think that can help you be successful. The next form on the right-hand side talks about the Success Center and some of the software programs that we have available on the computers that you may want to check into. CareerScope is a program that helps you or will ask you some questions and help you decide maybe if you're in the right program area if you're undecided. But I'm thinking all of you are probably pretty sure of what you want to do here at Southeastern Tech. But you might want to read through that. Your parking decal, because you'll be getting that tonight, you want to fill that little form out. There's some regulations on the right-hand side. There is a short form on the left-hand side. You'll fill this out when you go to get your ID picture. You'll present this form, and you also need it for your parking decal. You're going to need your tag number from your vehicle. So maybe before you do your you go in there to get your ID picture, you may want to make sure you have your tag number because you will need that. There's a new student questionnaire. We want to know how we're doing. If we're doing something really great, let us know. If we're doing something not so great, let us know. When you let us know, we try to evaluate how we're doing everything and to try to make it better. There's a special population survey. So basically on this survey, we want to know if you're a student with a disability, if you're going to need any accommodations, single parent, displaced homemaker. This information stays with us. So we would like for you to complete this information. We just want to know a little bit about our students, who's coming back to school, and that helps us to set up resources, services, and programs to address maybe some of the specific issues that students in those particular areas may experience. So please take time to complete those before you leave today. We would greatly appreciate it. Now, some of the other services we have available at Southeastern Tech for our students. I talked about the free tutoring. I talked a little bit about our Success Lab. We have what's called a lending library, which has become really popular. What we do is try to help those students who are having difficulty purchasing their books. So if you, it's a last resort. So if you don't have enough funds to purchase your books, you don't have family or friends that can help you do that, we may be able to help you through the lending library. You'll come, you'll speak with me, and if I have the book available, I can loan you the book for the semester. But the first thing you must do is, hopefully you have all done that, apply for your financial aid, have completed that process, if you have financial aid, you must use that first before you can even be considered for any type of assistance through the Linden Library. I will open the Linden Library tomorrow morning, beginning tomorrow morning, at about 8:15. I will be located in the Success Lab, which is room 166. It's right down the hall from the financial aid. And I know you all probably know where financial aid is. So room 166, which is the Success Lab, I'll open the Linden Library. So if you think you may need some assistance, come by and talk to me. We also have services for students with disabilities. So if you are a student, you had some services in the past, maybe you need extra time, maybe you need a quiet room to test in, then you can come and speak with me about that. I'll be available to discuss those things with you on maybe Thursday, and I'll be in my office, which is room 108 in the admissions area. And we also have provided for our students career guidance. So once you are in your program, you're nearing completion of your program, you may have some questions about interviewing for a job. How do you find a job? Where do you start? We have someone here, Mr. Lance Helms, who can help you do that. He can help you improve your resume writing skills, improve your interviewing skills, and give you some insight on how to start that job search process. And he will also maybe send your resume out to some companies to help you find a job. So keep that in mind. He'll come up when I'm done, and so you'll see who he is and give you a little bit of information if you need to contact him about that. Also, if you're interested in work study, students can work on campus through their financial aid. You may have seen students maybe working at the front desk. You may have seen students and working in the library. You can be one of those students as well. Mr. Lance Helms will be the person you would need to talk to get more information on that. I have a few students here that I'm going to ask to come on stage. And I'm asking these students to come up because at one point they were where you are. They were sitting out there. They were at new student orientation. They were probably just a little bit nervous, maybe a little bit overwhelmed, and maybe had some questions they were afraid to ask. So we're going to have them come up, and we're going to ask them some questions, and hopefully there'll be questions that you're having right now, and we'll be able to answer those for you. One of our students on stage is very shy, but it's okay. It is okay. Can you guess who the shy one is? And you know his name. So what I want them to start out with is I want them to introduce themselves and tell you what program they're in.
My name is
Sheree
Floyd. I'm in the medical assisting program.
My name is Jonathan Flowers. Just completed automotive technology program. I'm now part of building and building technology.
My name is Daquan Dupree. I'm part of capital.
Now, the reason I had Daquan go last, I'm not trying to pick on him, but he is the shy one. So I was trying to give him a few seconds to get his nerves together. He did really well. Thank you, Daquan. These are just a few questions. What I want you all to do is think back to the moment when you first arrived at STC and you were sitting in these seats. What were you thinking? Tell us, what were you thinking? How were you feeling about the process, about being back in school?
I just feel nervous right now.
Of course, I was nervous and excited, and is that what I'm saying?
Yes.
I was. I'm 40 years old, and I came back to school last year after doing a few things for my family instead of doing things for myself. And I finally decided I would come back to school. And so I was just very, like, very excited to be coming back. And I'm very excited I will be finishing my program in July.
I guess I was kind of nervous and excited as well. I'd just gotten out of the military for 10 years, so not being in school for that long and not, you know, not knowing what to expect coming into back to school and knowing what courses I was going to have to take, it was kind of overwhelming.
I remember when I started school, I was nervous. I didn't know what to ask. I didn't know who to ask. And I really felt like just walking out and going back home. Does anyone feel like that? Bit? Great. Okay. So maybe we're doing something right here. What do you wish someone had told you when you first began? Is there anything you wish we had told you that since you've been here, you found out? Or we did such a great job, we told you everything you needed to know.
Basically, every question I had was answered by either an instructor or by one of the members of the office area. Financial aid was very helpful, Ms. Melanie, helping me with my VA submissions, and course instructors and their school registrar really helped out setting up classes and putting me towards a career that I wanted to go into at the time.
I'm Jonathan. I found everybody here very helpful, and they were always there to answer any questions that I had. So I didn't have to, you know, wonder who I needed to go to. Financial aid, and financial aid, they're wonderful. I always dealt with Ms. Etheridge. She's always there to answer any questions. Anybody that you go to, they're just open and friendly, and I mean, you can feel free to ask them anything, and they're going to help you to the best of their ability.
Like Jonathan and Sheree, everybody was very helpful in helping me find the career that I wanted to choose.
See, he's so shy, but we were able to help him and he's still here. He talked to us. Right. So I've talked about some of the services that we offer at Southeastern Tech, and some of you may have utilized some of those services yourselves, but which ones have you found to be most beneficial? We know financial aid, because you know, financial aid is, you know, they're very customer friendly over there. But are there any other things that you've used or needed help with and Southeastern Tech was able to assist you with that?
I am work study. I went and saw Lance Helms and talked to him because I needed a part-time job to help me, you know, finance beyond financial aid to come to school. So I've enjoyed doing that. I've been a work study in the dental hygiene building since September of last year. And any of you who are needing a part-time job, looking for something, Lance is the one to talk to. And like I said, everybody here is very friendly and willing to help you. And anywhere that you get put is gonna be a great place to work.
Like Sheree, I'm also work study for Mr. Travis Akers, who's the head of security here for STC. I've as well been a work study since September, so Mr. Lansham can really help you out if you need some extra on the side to help you out and knowing you can keep your grades up well. Also, the library, and the librarian is Liv Asher. She's very helpful if you need to check out books, write a paper if you need to do, use computers to do work, print out stuff. I know with myself taking an automotive service excellence test, they have the practice tests that are available there, as well as basically anything you need. If they don't have it, they will try and get it for you.
Have any of you ever felt like quitting?
Every day I wake up. I did, when I first got out and started back to school, I actually dropped out for a semester. It actually hurts you in the long run if you drop out. Don't ever quit. Don't withdraw unless you really have to, because it's going to hurt you financially and it will hurt you in the long run. I know that for my HOPE grant, it cut me back to being on probation, which meant it was horrible. So don't drop out and withdraw from anything if at all possible. But since then, since I got straightened up and everybody got me back on the right path, you know, I have thought about quitting because I'm so close to finishing. There's no need to quit now.
So far, there hasn't been a time that I felt like quitting. Any time where I've gotten a little overwhelmed, there's always been somebody that I could talk to, and they encourage me, and you know, just to continue. I'm on the right path, and pretty soon I'll see the end of it. So, no, I haven't felt like quitting.
I haven't felt like quitting until today. I felt like I'm talking in front of all of y'all.
I'm going to tell y'all a little bit about this later about him, but he's going to be okay. He'll be okay. I want to say a little bit about what Jonathan said about withdrawing from classes and how it can potentially affect your financial aid. So be careful about that. There are sometimes some situations beyond our control where you may have to withdraw from a class. But be careful, try to manage your time, try to manage your course load. Don't take more than you can handle. I know you really want to get out of here. Some students may want to take 5-6 classes because you're here and you've got to get out. You have a goal in mind, you need to go to work. And we do understand that, and we want you to do that. But sometimes when you take on too much, it actually hinders that process. So balance your time, make sure the course load that you're taking, you're not overwhelming yourself. When you overwhelm yourself, then you feel like, well, maybe I can't do it, maybe I should drop out, but that's not the case. You may have just taken on too much. But if if there's a situation where you need to withdraw from the class, it is okay. You will come and you'll talk with someone in admissions. We'll talk you through the process. We'll try to give you as much information as we can, how can potentially affect you, how it can potentially maybe you make you owe money back or suspend your financial aid. We're going to do everything we can so that you can make the most informed decision that you can. And then if there's anything we can do to help you stay in school, we'll try to do that as well. So the important thing is, and you'll hear me say this more than once, don't be afraid to ask questions. We've heard most, I won't say everything, but we've heard quite a few things before, and we've been able to help students work through many situations. So do not be afraid to ask. Come up front, you can talk with me, Mr. Lance Helms, Ms. Cindy Phillips, any of our staff members, your instructors. Talk to 2 or 3 of us to get just a good, well-rounded idea of maybe how to handle your situation. So ask questions. Don't be afraid to ask us any questions. We may just have the perfect answer for you. So, Jonathan, you said you quit.
Yeah.
What made you come back?
When I dropped out, I had some problems going on getting out of the military and getting settled back in. What made me come back was I knew that I had started something. I don't start something I'm not going to finish. So if you have the mentality I do, you know that you're going to have to complete it or it's always going to nag you no matter what you're doing in life. I knew that I had started the program, and even though I had dropped out and lost all of that time that I put in, that I could come back and I could get the help that I needed to set everything back straight and complete the program.
So sometimes things happen, like I said, out of our control. Try to make a plan, and sometimes even our best planning, occasionally things will happen. Just never give up. If you have to stop for that period of time, just make a plan that you're going to come back and complete whatever that goal is. Okay, so while you're here, I'm sure you're going to take at least one class that's going to be really challenging. Maybe at least one. And some of you, Cherie said she'll be finished in July, so she's probably had a tough class. Daquan is in accounting. I hear that accounting is very tough. Although he's a really smart dude, I'm sure he's had at least one tough class. So What made the class tough, and what did you do to successfully get through that class?
I think probably the toughest courses I took were in the automotive program. Just because you know anything about cars, there's so many moving parts, and you got to know what goes wrong, when they go wrong, and how to fix it. But other than that, probably the hybrid courses, which is half online and half in classrooms, such as College 1000. Just keeping up with the schedule and keeping everything turned in on time. Because if it's not turned in, they don't give you extra days, that's it. So that zero really hurts in the long run. So if anybody's got College 1000 or UPL 1000, just stay up to date with the syllabus and keep your grades turned in.
In the medical assisting program, the hardest classes that I've had are medical terminology and anatomy and physiology. And one of the reasons that they were difficult were I took those classes online. I wasn't in the classroom because I was trying to do as much as possible and so that I would be able to start my program in September. And like Jonathan said, I mean, the most important thing if you're taking an online class or a hybrid class is doing the work that is in your syllabus to do. You don't have a teacher there saying, okay, now this is what you have to do and this is when it needs to be turned in. You have to read that syllabus. It's your responsibility to keep up with it. It's your responsibility to do the reading, to do the homework, and to get them submitted. So doing that stuff, just having the discipline to keep all of that up with everything that I have going on at home, that was the most difficult part that I've had.
So, some things you can take away from that is staying on top of your work. If you have a difficult class and you get behind, that makes it almost twice as difficult. So staying on top of everything, things that I've said before, seek tutoring, ask for help, you'll get through it. You know, you're coming to school, you're learning, not only are you learning everything that we're teaching you in the classes, but you are also developing new skills. And some of this is going to be very uncomfortable. But just remember, you're developing these skills. The more you start, in the beginning, it'll be uncomfortable. But the more you use them, they will become a part of you. So make a plan now to try to stay on top of your work. Ask questions, study. Make sure you schedule time to study. In your college survival class, I think many of you probably enrolled in that class for this semester, you receive some information on study techniques and things that you can use. You will use those. I've had students that come to my office and they say they have trouble, they've been studying and it's not working. And so when I start going through some of the various techniques to study, they say, I remember I had that in my college survival class, but they didn't pay attention at that time. I'm telling you to pay attention because those are some things that you will use to help you be successful. Now, we're going to talk a little bit about student activities. I'm one of the advisors for our student leadership organization. We have several student clubs and organizations for you to become involved in that provide some different types of opportunities. You get to go on trips, meet students from other schools, compete in competitions, and you're competing with students from other schools. So there's some really nice opportunities in being involved. And these students are all involved in our Student Leadership Council. And I told them at our very first meeting, which involved the minister, that they were probably going to speak on stage. Something was going to come up, and I was going to get them to speak in front of the group of students. And they said, we're not doing that. Oh no, you're not going to get me. But I think as being a student leader, that's one of the experiences you need to have that can help you in the long run when you go into a job, as you advance, you may become a supervisor, you may have to do a training or something like that. So these are just some skills outside of the classroom and opportunities that our students get. And if you get in student leadership or any of the organizations, you're going to probably end up speaking in front of the group, and you'll do very well. So what I want these Student Leadership Council members to do is tell us why they got involved. And I think, are you in more than one club or is it just student? Okay, some of them are involved even in more than one student organization. So if you can tell us why you got involved and how you think it has benefited you so far. LaQuan, you can take that first.
I got involved in student leadership because, as y'all know, I'm real shy. I don't like talking about people. So I thought it would help me be able to come out of my shell and be a more productive person.
And he likes those free lunches too.
I got involved in student leadership because I walked in my class one day and my advisor says, I want you to go be in student leadership. So. I'm not one to say no, so off I went. And yeah, they do feed you every meeting, and that's always really good. And but I also did it because I know it's going to look good when I'm filling out my resume to have student leadership, because they are doing everything they can to help us improve our leadership skills. And when I go and apply for a job, and everything is going to help me, the things that I'm learning is going to help me. So.
I'm the historian and parliamentarian for the Student Leadership Council, as well as part of the welding division of Skills USA. And I'm currently president of the Future Tech Automotive Club that we also have here. I got involved because I've been here and I was almost done, and I knew I was going to continue with my school and trying to get more everything I can out while I'm here. Student leadership, I had heard about it during one of our lunch and learns here, and I went up and asked about it, and I was told what to do to get involved in it, and then I just naturally decided that I would run for office. I just did this thing here. But Future Tech, the Automotive Club, I actually was the one that came up with the idea, the one that set it up. And that's why I actually become president, but it may just sound like, oh, they're not about a bunch of car nuts and they don't want to do nothing about fast cars and break stuff. No, we actually do a lot of community service, a lot of stuff that every other club also does, with community service and food drives and stuff of the nature. And the skills, I've always been a hands-on kind of person. So skills just sound like something I might want to do, build something to maybe possibly win some kind of award to state or national.
So hopefully you all will explore those opportunities further, and I hope that you all will become involved in a student organization and learn firsthand some of those experiences and benefits of being involved in a student organization. Some final words. I did mention this morning, but I want to be sure to mention it tonight. All of you have a student email account. And students don't like to check that account. Check your student email account. Just make it a habit of checking that account once or twice a week. Any important information that we want to inform you of, our opportunities, if we have new scholarships to become available that you can apply for, we're going to send you that information through your student email account. If there are updates for financial aid or any great news that's coming out, we're going to send it to you through your student email account. So be sure to check that. Get in the habit of checking that. There's a lunch and learn. Somebody mentioned a lunch and learn. What a lunch and learn is something we plan for students during the lunch hour. Well, it's an informative session, and we also provide lunch. One is coming up in the next week, so keep your ears open, check your student email, and I think it's going to talk about all the services, you know about that one, all the services and everything that...
If I'm not mistaken, the next lunch learn is the 14th.
January 14th.
And it is over the computer lab, I believe, Mr. Graham's mostly.
Okay. So we have some really good lunch and learn sessions, and you don't want to miss them. You just show up and, you know, we feed you lunch and hopefully you'll be a more informed student. Also, we know we're covering a lot. You all have probably, or at least 99% of you have completed the online registration. You can refer online orientation, I'm sorry. You can refer back to that as often as you like. So if I think there's names, contact numbers in there, if you forget anything, you can't remember that name, you can always go back to the online orientation and look up that information, or you can just take a shortcut and come up front and ask one of us, and we'll try to get you to the right point. I would like to thank this group of students for helping us out. I think they did an excellent job. And maybe next time they will be you on stage. Now we're going to show a short video. We have some refreshments for you. So when you come into the student center to get your ID picture and your parking decal, please be sure to stop by and pick up a couple of slices of pizza and talk with us. Thank you again for choosing Southeastern Tech.